Hey, what's going on, everyone? My name is Prestige. Welcome back to the channel. This is episode number one of 5 things you probably didn't know about Call of Duty World War II. Remember, everybody, if you learned something new from this video or you just want to show some amazing support, make sure to take a second of your time to click that like button down below. But let's get things started with number 5 and a fan favorite streak that doesn't appear to be in the beta as of right now. That would be an advanced UAV. As of right now, you're currently able to call in an advanced UAV by using 3 recon planes at the same time. Now, this is definitely something that may have gone past your vision, or possibly you've never even noticed it, and that's because recon planes cost 500 score. It's not often that everybody has their planes at the same exact time, but if you call in 3 at once, everybody on the minimap will appear with an arrow pointing in the direction that they're looking, similar to advanced UAVs. The sweep is a little bit faster as well. It's not always available like an advanced UAV, but you're still able to see the direction in which enemies are pointing, and of course, if they're looking in your direction or not. This is a really nice tactic to use, especially in modes like domination, and of course, as long as the enemy team aren't taking out your recon planes, you can call them in over time and continuously have a constant advanced UAV. We did a little bit of testing to see, depending on how many planes you have in the sky, is that how fast the sweep is, and unfortunately the speed never changes. If you have 3 planes, the speed of the sweep will be the same if you have 6 planes in the air. Taking that number 4 spot, we're talking about the care package. Now, you know, and I know, that it falls very, very slowly. A lot of people wish that the care package would come in a lot faster, especially during tense situations. But did you know that you can make it fall faster by simply shooting the parachute? It allows it to break free and fall from its parachute harness, dropping to the earth a little bit faster than it normally would. This helps in those tense situations, and it allows you to get your care package before the enemies quickly approach. However, keep in mind that the enemies are also able to do this, and they'll be able to capture your package faster if you end up dying while it's still falling out of the sky. Coming into that number 3 position is a brand new feature that has never seen the light of day in Call of Duty multiplayer. It's only been seen in the campaign before, and it's called Lingering Death. Normally, when you kill an enemy in the multiplayer, they just fold up like a lawn chair and that's the end of it. But with this game, if you end up killing an enemy, depending on how you do it, with a bouncing Betty, a frag grenade, a sticky grenade, a Molotov cocktail, a flamethrower, or hell, even sometimes with your normal weapon, the enemy will fall over and they'll be screaming in pain, holding their wounds. If an enemy gets blown up by a bouncing Betty or a grenade, they could lay there with their leg completely severed, holding their stump while the blood is just gushing out until they eventually pass out from all the blood loss and die. No more just folding up like a lawn chair and being done with it. You get to actually hear people suffer, depending on how you do it now, and that's pretty damn brutal. Moving on to that number 2 spot is a very small feature that may have been overlooked by many people, but I honestly really enjoy it. And that is, when you dolphin dive into a puddle of water, into a puddle of mud, you will actually continuously and gradually get more and more mud on your character's hands and arms, and of course, on the weapon that you're using. This is pretty damn cool, because when you go to inspect your weapon, you can see that it's completely covered in mud. This can also happen periodically while laying prone in specific areas and shooting your weapon. Mud will kick up off the ground and effectively end up on your hands and on the weapon itself. It goes away after a certain amount of time, and I noticed when you die and respawn, it ends up clean again, but still, a nice little feature that didn't necessarily need to be added to the game. I really appreciate it though. Now finally, taking that number 1 spot, we're talking about those pesky bouncing Bettys, aka the S-Mine, that was added during day 2 of the beta. The S-Mine is a lethal equipment that replaces your frag grenade, and you plant it into the ground. It's pressure sensitive, so when an enemy walks by, it pops up out of the ground and destroys or damages anything within a 4 meter radius. I've heard a lot of people saying that they think these things are really annoying. But did you know that you can actually survive a point-blank hit with this thing by simply going prone? You don't need to do it in a dive either. As soon as you hear that audible cue that you're about to get killed by a bouncing Betty, simply laying prone on your belly allows you to keep your legs and fight another day. Although you will take a little bit of damage, you aren't required to use the armored division and of course the added flak damage bonus that you get from it. In this video clip you're watching now, I'm using infantry, and I was able to survive a point-blank hit twice with my own bouncing Betty and of course an enemy's bouncing Betty that was right around the corner. This is a really nice thing to know, especially moving forward in the beta when we're going to start seeing more and more people using it in week 2. Now when the full game comes out, I don't know if this is going to be changed, but right now I think it's perfect exactly where it is. You could take unsuspecting players off guard and kill them with your bouncing Betty, but the more keen-eared players will be able to avoid the Betty blast altogether. And who knows, maybe moving forward there will be an ability that increases the lethal blast radius. I'm sure hoping that this isn't the case, but either way, lay on your belly, keep your legs, and fight another day. Anyway guys, that is going to conclude today's episode of 5 Things You Probably Didn't Know About Call of Duty World War II. If you enjoyed the video, or if you learned something new, click the like button down below, subscribe for more 5 Things episodes coming very, very soon, and of course in November when the full game launches. And guys, if you're already subscribed, don't forget to click that notification button. Stay up to date on when I upload videos each and every day. Thank you all so much for the continued support, and I will see you on the next video. Peace.